Engelbert from a new project in Luxembourg,
yes.
A new branch. Yes. We need to move your bike.
Yeah.
Project. It's an idea coming from Denmark. In fact, probably all of you know that in Denmark everybody is using his bike every day to go to work, to go to school or whatever. And it happens that a Danish guy called Ole passed every day in front of an elderly house, a nursing house. And every day he saw next to it old guy sitting in a chair just waiting the day to pass. Every day on the way back, on the way in the morning and on the way back in the evening, that old guy was sitting there. So after a few times, Ole had the idea to stop and start talking about that with that old person. And they decided all together to propose to the home to organize some tour with some kind of rickshaw like this one. So Ole called the home and had a very quickly positive answer. So he immediately organized a ride with him. Well, first he rented himself a rickshaw and then organized a ride with an old lady. That was a quick ride, only 1 hour or so, and soon as she was back, the director of the home came and said, "What have you done with that lady? She's so happy now." And Ole said, "Nothing but riding." So that was the quick start of that new idea. And a few days later, he started to propose the ride to all the person in the home, and he had, in fact, a huge positive feedback return. So he wrote a letter to the city of Copenhagen to ask if it was possible to have a fund to buy more of those rickshaw. And again, he got a positive answer. The city proposed him to buy 5 more rickshaw and organize some kind of demonstration. So he did it, and that was again far above his expectation. He had 5 bikes, but he had also 5 pilots. Pilots are the bikers able to ride those special bikes. So he had 5 rickshaw, 15 pilots, but also hundreds of cyclists going around and looking what was happening. TV was there, even BBC was there, so that was really some kind of kick to really start the association. It was only in 2012, it's quite recent. Don't believe it's an old idea, it's really new, and now it's spreading all over the almost all over the world, mainly in Scandinavian countries, but also in Anglo-Saxon countries, and now even in Luxembourg. The second experience he made was to organize a trip from Denmark to Hamburg in Germany. That's a long way, so there were about, I don't remember how many there were, yeah, there were also 5 rickshaw, 15 pilots, and they made all the way from Denmark to Hamburg with their own energy. Batteries were not strong enough to feed the electric engine for all the ways, but they were all so happy and all over the way that they finally managed to reach Hamburg. Both parties, I mean, not only the pilots and Ole, but also the old person. Both parties were so happy. some people say that they do not need any more tranquilizer to sleep. So they had a new experience that was far different from just sitting in a chair waiting the day to pass. a blind person also made a special remark, saying that he could even feel the wind in his hair. That's something he had lost. The feeling has been lost since a long time. There are many stories like that. Also, a pilot, a bike rider, was heavy, too heavy, and had to lose some weight. And his doctor just gave him a prescription: just ride a rickshaw for the association. And he did, and he lost weight some weight. Also, there are sometimes some contacts getting made between the old person and the pilots. For example, one young guy had almost made new grandparents because he came not as a job, but he just came when he had the time. That could be today, and then 1 week later, he just pop up to the home and then decide to have a walk. So that's more family organization, no planning. That looks like those old people like it. So there is also a remark a weaker lady has done. She said she feel alive again, because she hardly could move. I will tell you about that a little bit later. She could hardly move, so just sitting in the bike and visiting the city again make her feel like she was 20 again. One more thing, when they went to Hamburg, they left all the wheelchair in the bus. They did not use it anymore. The people were in the bike, and if not, they just tried to walk again slowly like they could, but not using the vision. who are the riders? The riders are anybody. Any one of you can do. You just need a small training. It takes 5 minutes or 10 minutes. It's not so difficult to ride such bike. It's just tricky, and you have to be careful with speeds, especially. Ole had no problem at all to find any riders in Copenhagen in Denmark, so I hope that we will find a lot of riders here in Luxembourg. So what are we doing here? We are doing exactly the same in Luxembourg, but it's brand new. It's only 15 days that we have started the project. The project was in fact initiated by a German lady, a Danish lady called Helle. She's not here today, unfortunately. So she, as a Danish lady, she knew about that association, and she proposed it to create it here. And so we did, together with the Ministère de la Mobilité and the Embassy of Denmark. It took a few months to do it. And finally, we got the support of Fondation Pescator. They agreed to buy, up to now it's just renting this bike. And we are testing, in fact, this service in Fondation Pescator. And up to now, everybody is really happy. Both sides, I mean, Fondation and the resident, and we, the pilot. We are only two pilots up to now, plus a few in the Fondation itself. So if you are interested to be a pilot, you can call the Fondation and ask. We will organize a small training, and that's it. Then you don't have to be ready to cycle every day or every week. It's just whenever you need, whenever you want, or whenever you are free. Up to now, as it's a training period, we do not go very far away. We just stay in the near the park, and we hope that soon that the elevator will be ready, so we will be able to have longer ride in the Grund and Baffental, and also hopefully in the city. The only problem we had today, I have to talk about problem, is the weather. So since we are riding, it has been raining almost every day, except yesterday and maybe today. As it's the only problem, I guess we can talk about a real success. I have a few observations that I've done. In other countries, there are a lot of riders, so I hope to find more today, maybe. It's funny because in the Fondation Pescator, the pensioners who are volunteer to run are mainly ladies. I had only two men to ride, all the others are ladies. I don't know the reason. And also concerning the Fondation Pescator, I have to say that the person is extremely nice and helpful.